Hi friends, let us see how to evaluate inverse Fourier transform using FFT. So we'll be performing inverse FFT. So this is also called as IFFT. Now there are basically two types of IFFT. One is 8-point and one is 4-point for radix 2 FFTs. Let us see today how to perform an 8-point IFFT, and then we will see how to perform 4-point IFFT. So the 8-point, for an 8-point IFFT, again we require 8 parallel lines for input and output. So let us draw 8 parallel lines. So we have taken 8 parallel lines. So in inverse Fourier transform, we will be given x of k and we are supposed to give x of n. Right. So according to the formula of inverse Fourier transform, or we say IDFT, we will get x of n, which is equal to 1 by n summation k goes from 0 to n minus 1 x of k w n raised to minus n k. So we have a negative index in the twiddle factor and we have to divide the final answer by 1 by n. Then we will get our respective sample value. Okay, so let us implement this formula in this flow graph. So the input now will be x of k. So this will be the input side, which is x of k, and my output will be now x of n. Right, so x of k will be written as x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, x of 4, x of 5, x of 6, and x of 7. So this is in order. Then I will put the bigger crisscrosses in the first stage. So we will have a larger crisscrosses that is utilizing the 8 lines. We will be putting the first crisscross. So this is the first one. And the second one, then we have third one, and we have finally the fourth one. Reverse direction also, first to the fifth one, then second to sixth one, and so on so forth. All the crisscrosses we will be making. Then we'll be putting minus one in the last four lines, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, and minus 1. Then the next stage, or the next immediate step, is to put the twiddle factors. The twiddle factor in IFFT will have a negative index according to the formula. So whenever I'll put here the twiddle factor, it will be with the negative index. So the twiddle factors will be W8 raised to 0, associated with 0, plus and minus does not matter. Then we have W8 raised to, now it will be minus 1. Then we will have W8 raised to minus 2, and finally we will have W8 raised to minus 3. Okay, then we will go for smaller 4 sets of crisscross. So in the fourth set of crisscross, I will have first line goes to third line, second line goes to the fourth line in the way. Go like this. Okay, and then we will have minus 1 as the multipliers on the last two lines. Now we have done with the stage 2. Let us go to stage 3. Before going to stage 3, we will have multipliers on the last two lines over here. And the multipliers are given as W 8 raised to 0 and W 8 raised to minus 2. Here also W 8 raised to 0, and here the multiplier is W 8 raised to minus 2. Then we will go for the final stage. In the final stage, we will have only two crisscross. So we will have two lines crisscross. Okay, and then we will put minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 everywhere. Okay, now this actually have produced my outputs, but if I write x of n as this input sequence, then it will be wrong, because what we have done is we have performed only this much of the part of the operation. But still, to achieve x of n, I need to divide each sequence by 1 by n. So each output now will be multiplied by 1 by n. That is dividing each sequence by n. So it will be 1 by, here the value of n is 8. So it will be 1 by 8. 1 by 8. 1 by 8. And so on to all samples, I will divide by 1 by 8. Okay, now what should be the order of x of n? The order of x of n is in bit reverse manner. That means they are not in order. The order of x of n is x of 0, then x of 4, then x of 2, then x of 6, then x of 1, x of 5, x of 3, and x of 7. So this is the final sequence at the output. But I cannot write in this order as my final output. So when I write x of n, I will always arrange them in the proper order. And I will write it like x of 0, then x of 1, and so on and so forth till x of 7. So for an 8-point IFFT, the flow graph looks very similar to DIFFT, with interchanging the positions of x of k and x of n and changing the sign of the twiddle factors. So x of k becomes the input, x of n becomes the output. Bigger crisscrosses at the first stage, and as the stage proceeds further, the crisscrosses becomes shorter and shorter. After each crisscross, we have multipliers, and the multipliers are the twiddle factors with the negative indexes. After the third stage, we are dividing each sequence by 1 by 8. So we will be dividing the sequence by 8. So that is how the final output we will achieve, and then we can rearrange and get the final output. Thank you.